These popular YouTube videos claim to explain the twins' paradox from Einstein's special relativity. We will figure out what they are doing wrong because the twins' paradox, or the clock paradox, cannot be avoided. This is meant to supplement my video that goes into much more detail about debunking special relativity. From my video, you'll remember this paper that Einstein wrote in 1918. On the second page is where Einstein describes the clock paradox. Up here, he describes how moving clocks slow down. And then here, he discusses the peer-to-peer reference frames that are built into his principle of relativity. And then at the bottom, he describes how both clocks can't be slow relative to each other. Now realize, with the peer-to-peer reference frames, you always get two different answers because you have to calculate each reference frame as if it was at rest. So every time, each one of these two answers will have a clock that is slow relative to the other answer. And there's no way around this. It is a bug that is built into the peer-to-peer reference frames and a moving clock that slows. These two ideas are not compatible with each other. Let's start with Nick Lucid's video from the Science Asylum. So many of the relativity believers will use a space-time diagram to help explain the twins' paradox. The problem is they will start throwing calculations at you that look like they are transforming the space and time paths for each frame. This is not true because there's only one rest frame that is being calculated here. In Nick's video, you'll see it's just the yellow spaceship for all the calculations. Now you see that rocket clone is the one at rest. At this point, you do more calculations and you will get a second answer that is completely different than the first. This is because the spaceship is now moving relative to rocket clone, and spaceship clock will slow. So what the relativists usually fail to do is create two separate space-time diagrams. You can see that the rest frame for the spaceship is here, and the rest frame for rocket clone is here. In this frame, rocket clone's clock is slowing. In this frame, the spaceship's clock is slowing. So now, which twin is aging less? When either reference frame has the ability to claim to be at rest, and then the one on the move has a slower clock, these two principles are not compatible. And this is a cause for a lot of the illogic that is in this theory. Okay, so we're going to switch over to the other video. And again, the point of these videos is to show you that there is no twin paradox. And that is not correct. The twin paradox always exists in the special theory of relativity. This video has the same problem that Nick's video has. They only use one space-time diagram and then confuse you by making calculations between the rest frame and the moving frame. A second diagram would switch this purple line to the rest frame, and the green line would go out at this angle. Unfortunately, Amber did not do that in this video, and 2.5 million people saw only one side of the story. Okay, that'll do it for this video, and for more information, you can check out my other video that will actually go into the spherical wave proof. The failure of that proof is exactly what disproves Einstein's special theory of relativity. Okay, everybody, thanks for listening.